You're back in Noir Alley, and I'm still your host, Eddie Muller. Today felt like the right time for another fix of foreign film noir. But since I'm kind of hungover, I don't want to read subtitles. So today's overseas offering comes from England. It's Brighton Rock, released in the UK in 1948, starring 24-year-old Richard Attenborough, many years before knighthood would affix Sir to his name. The movie is based on the 1938 novel of the same name by Graham Greene, making this the fourth Greene story I've presented on Noir Alley. This Gun for Hire, Ministry of Fear, and The Third Man were all based on Graham Greene entertainments, which is what he called his crime and espionage tales, to separate them from his more high-minded literary output. Brighton Rock tells the tale of a callous and ambitious spiv named Pinky Brown, that's Attenborough, who sees a chance to wrest control of the criminal gangs operating in the seaside resort of Brighton. Greene had spent idyllic summers as a young boy in Brighton, located on the southern coast, about 50 miles from London. But Brighton took a dark turn during the Depression when a couple of highly publicized trunk murders and running battles between razor-wielding gangs trying to muscle in on the racetrack business that was a big part of Brighton's economy. Against this backdrop, Greene set a story filled with metaphysical musings on the nature of good and evil. Pinky is obsessed by Catholic doctrine. He believes his tortured soul may be evil incarnate, and Attenborough's performance makes Pinky Brown one of the scariest characters ever in a British film. Offsetting his malevolence are a pair of female characters. Rose, played by Carol Marsh, is an almost appallingly innocent girl who falls under Pinky's spell. And Ida, a blousy vaudeville veteran who serves as detective and moral compass. Hermione Baddeley is aces as Ida, giving the film much-needed decency, common sense, and good humor. Attenborough and Baddeley had already appeared in a stage version of Brighton Rock that ran for more than 100 performances at London's Garrick Theatre. Much of the play's cast reprised their roles for the film, with the notable exception of Dulcie Gray, who'd played Rose on stage. For the film, the producers sought a fresh-faced newcomer, and Carol Marsh was chosen from among 3,000 young women who auditioned. It's the role she's most known for, somewhat to her chagrin, as I'll explain later. There was no doubt, however, that Attenborough would return to play Pinky. He and the film's director, John Bolting, had served in the Royal Air Force together during the war. They even made a fictionalized feature based on their exploits called Journey Together, sort of a 1945 version of Top Gun. That film was co-written by playwright Terence Rattigan, who'd adapt the script for Brighton Rock. And Journey Together was photographed by Harry Waxman, whose camera work gives Brighton Rock its richly sinister atmosphere. Brighton Rock is one of the high points on the resume of identical twins John and Roy Bolting, who alternated roles as producer and director, depending on the project. For this one, Roy produced, John directed. Both had served Britain with distinction during World War II, and like much of what was happening at the same time in Hollywood, they returned to commercial cinema and displayed a darker and more disturbing tone. Critics at the time were not kind to Brighton Rock. The Daily Mirror called it false, nasty, cheap sensationalism and declared no parent will want their children to see it. Graham Greene, a former film critic himself, replied, "Your critics' disgust is an indication that one purpose of the film, the presentation of a character possessed by evil, has been successfully achieved." Released in the United States in 1951 under the title Young Scarface, here is Brighton Rock.